story with, as they say, a glittering cast, that doesn't take place in London, Paris, New York, or Las Vegas. It takes place here, in Batley, a walled town in the west riding of Yorkshire, a long way from the glamorous world of stars and neon lights. But one local resident, former fairground barker and small-time bingo operator, James Corrigan, noticed that Batley lies at the heart of an urban sprawl that embraces 3 million people. 3 million people starved of entertainment. Corrigan was born into a family of travelling showmen. He never went to school, but he inherited his grandfather's flair for showmanship, which was to manifest itself in Batley in 1966. With his own modest savings and a huge loan which he somehow arranged with a brewery, he wanted to build a theatre and a club combined, which would seat 1,500 people. It was, to say the least, a crazy dream, made even more bizarre by the fact that the chosen site had once been part of a sewerage works. The locals had heard of the saying, where there's muck, there's brass, but this was ridiculous.
People used to come out in the cars from Leeds because they thought of it insane.
The Bachelors were booked to be the opening attraction before a brick had been laid, and we were asked to come up to Batley to lay the foundation stone for a new club called Batley Variety Club. A mere 14 weeks later, Batley Variety Club opens its doors to the public, who paid £5 apiece to see the show. Few of the artists who were booked knew what to expect, or even how to find the place.
I think one of the amazing things about the club was that it was situated in such a funny place, really, when you think about it. If someone had said to me Batley 2 years before I went there, I'm sure I hadn't actually heard of the place. It seemed to be absolutely in the middle of no man's land.
And the thought of playing at Batley, you know, so a lot of stars used to think, well, where is Batley? You know, it seemed like out in the sticks, out in the frozen north.
I didn't even know it was in Yorkshire. I thought it really was north of Liverpool.
Of course, to try and find Batley is something else. I'll never forget when the first time I drove up there, I'd actually gone past it and I couldn't figure out why, because people had told me it was such a big place, and then somebody said, well, just turn around and go back the way you come. You can't miss it. It's on the right-hand side. I already had missed it, of course.
And when I pulled in, it was the most unimposing place I think I'd ever seen. I was expecting to see a big front and all that, but it was a very low building, like a low factory area. And that concealed what happened inside. Inside it went down in a big dip.
When I saw the place, the building, I thought, my God, what have I got myself into?
And, of course, when I got there, it looked rather austere. It looked like a fortress or something on the outside.
The fact that there was a slightly at the back of the club really didn't matter. What mattered was when you went inside the place.
So it was a theatre and a club combined. And that was the idea of Battle Variety Club. I didn't realise it would take off as it did do.
He took a tiny little town and put it on the map of the world, bringing the greatest stars of the world to his home.
Early in 1968, James Corrigan took a plane to New York and returned with a signed contract for the legendary Louis Armstrong. In June of that year, Satchmo played 2 weeks, and it was this engagement alone that gave Battle Variety Club a unique reputation.
And I felt, as a responsible person in show business, I'd make it my business to let all my friends in show business know that this was on the map. This Batley Variety Club was here to stay, and it would do themselves a lot of good by working it. I, in fact, rang Engelbert Humperdinck, that was sort of toying with the idea, and I said, yeah, you really enjoyed Engelbert.
Well, when we first heard about Batley and the first day, a nightclub, it was